Hi guys, this is Akash and today I will show you how to reach Qutub Minar. So Qutub Minar is located in South Delhi, and as you can see in the map, you can find the Google map and it will show you the location. It is in Seth Sarai, Mehroli 110030, and the location is nearby two metro station, that is Qutub Minar metro station and Saket metro station. And on the Google Maps app, you can see the reviews, the timings, the morning time when it is open, and how other people have rated with photos of the locality. It is always advised to watch and see before going to the monument location, because this will give you a prospect about how the locality is. Will you get a parking access nearby, or how far it is from the public transport? And the distance from both the metro station is around 2.2 kilometers, and the auto might charge you around 70 to 100 rupees depending, because on the timing and the demand, the price might vary. So there are two stations, as I said, you Qutub Minar metro station and Saket metro station. Both has same distance from the Qutub Minar complex. And if you're coming by your private vehicle, you can park the vehicle nearby the parkings available outside the Qutub Minar complex, and they will charge you rupees 10 depending. On per hour, sorry, they will charge you 10 rupees per hour, and that's very minimum amount they're charging. And now you can see where you can book the e-tickets, and it is always advised to you that you book your tickets while coming here, because the ticket counters will take time and there might be a huge line. So to avoid that, book online from ASI site, Archaeological Survey of India, and just select your date and the time of the visit. And next option will be your nationality, foreigner, SAARC or BIMSTEC nations, and the price will vary. Also, you need to provide how many adults are going, the name and the email address, and the ID proof, ID numbers of your passport, PAN card, driving license or voter ID, etc. And then you will need to just pay it through your UPI or your e-wallet, and then you will get a mail on your email ID mentioned. Also, you can download it from the post payment. You can download it from the site. कुतुब मीनार। कुतुब मीनार द टॉलेस्ट स्टोन टावर इन इंडिया वॉज कंसीव्ड बाय कुतुबुद्दीन ऐबक AD 1192 टू 1210 एज अ टावर ऑफ विक्ट्री अटैच टू क्वात उल इस्लाम मॉस्क। कुतुबुद्दीन कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट स्टोरी वाइल द सेकेंड थर्ड एंड द फोर्थ वर कंप्लीटेड बाय हिज सक्सेसर इल्तुतमिश AD 1211 टू 36। When it was damaged by the lightning in 1326 and 1368, the fourth story was dismantled and reconstructed by Firuz Tughlaq. AD 1351 to 88, with an additional story making it a five-storied structure. Later on in 1503, Sikandar Lodi, AD 1489 to 1517, also carried out stone restoration in the upper stories. With a height of 238 feet and 379 steps, although it is the highest stone tower in India, it would be pleasant surprise to know that its height is 5 feet less than that of Taj Mahal, 243 feet. The lowest story with alternate angular and circular fluting, the second with round ones, and the third with angular ones only, keeping throughout the same alignment, gives a pleasing vertical look to the minar. The projecting balconies with beautiful stalactite pendentives and its tiny alcoves further highlights its pleasing effect. The decorative inscription bands defines each story with its undulating curves. It has a diameter of 46 feet at the base and about 9 feet at the top. Qutub Minar. The Qutub Minar, also spelled as Qutub Minar and Qutub Minar, is a minaret and victory tower that forms part of Qutub complex. It is a UNESCO World Heritage Site in the Mehrauli area of New Delhi, India. It is one of the most visited tourist spots in the city due to its being one of the earliest that survives in Indian subcontinent. It can be compared to the 62-meter all-brick minaret of Jam in Afghanistan of C. 1190, which was constructed a decade or so before the probable start of Delhi Tower. The surfaces of both are elaborately decorated with inscriptions and geometric patterns. The Qutub Minar has a shaft that is fluted with superb stalactite bracketing under the balconies at the top of each stage. In general, minarets were slow to be used in India and are often detached from the main mosque where they exist. A synthesis of South Asian and Islamic architecture. The Victory Tower is a symbol of synthesis of traditional Islamic architecture and the Southwestern Asian design. Elizabeth Lamburn, Islam Beyond Empire, Mosque and Islamic Landscape in India and the Indian Ocean Studies, the Introduction of Islam in South Asia and how the region influenced the Islamic regional architecture. These newly arrived Muslims from the Islamic West escaped the Mongol Empire and emigrated to India, where they constructed religious centers. The Qutub Minar served as a central marker to these new Muslim communities, as well being a reminder of Islam's presence in area. The architecture of minarets varies greatly from that of the typical style and design of mosques constructed in the Middle East. The style of these structures is heavily influenced by local architecture such as Indic temples. This affected the different material techniques and decorations that were used in the construction of Qutub Minar. The minaret is unique in that historically these towers, minarets were uncommon in South Asian Islamic design until the 17th century. This lag is due to slow adoption of typical Middle Eastern style in India. It is also detached from the main mosque, showcasing how the native culture affected the design of a Middle Eastern structure. The Qutub Minar is seen as the earliest and the best example of a fusion or synthesis of Hindu-Muslim traditions. According to Ved Prakash in his essay, The Qutub Minar, from contemporary and near-contemporary sources. Like many mosques built in South Asia during the time period, the minarets were constructed by Hindu laborers and craftsmen but overseen by Muslim architects. This led to a construction that synthesizes both Hindu and Islamic religious architecture. Since the craftsmen were Hindu and unfamiliar with the Quran, the inscriptions are compilation of disarranged Quranic texts and other Arabic expressions. History. The Qutub Minar was built over the ruins of Lal Kot, the citadel of Dilaka. Qutub Minar was begun after Quwat-ul-Islam Mosque, which was started around 1192. By Qutb-ud-Din Aibak, first ruler of Delhi Sultanate. It is usually thought that the tower is named for Qutb-ud-Din Aibak, who began it. It is also possible that it is named after Khwaja Qutb-ud-Din Bakhita Kaki, a 13th century Sufi saint, because Shamsuddin Iltutmish was a devotee of his. The Minar is surrounded by several historical significant monuments of Qutb complex. Quwat-ul-Islam Mosque to the northeast of Minar was built by Qutbuddin Aibak in AD 1198. It is earliest extant mosque built by Delhi Sultanate. It consists of rectangular courtyard enclosed by cloisters erected with carved columns and architectural members of 27 Hindu and Jain temples, which were demolished by Qutbuddin Aibak as recorded in his inscription on the main eastern entrance. Later, a lofty arched screen was erected and the mosque was enlarged by Shamsuddin Iltutmish, AD 1210 to 35, and Alauddin Khilji. The iron pillar in the courtyard bears an inscription in Sanskrit in Brahmin script of 4th century AD, according to which the pillar was set up as Vishnu Divaja, standard of Vishnu, God, on the hill known as Vishnupada in memory of a mighty king named Chandra. The mosque complex is one of the earliest that survives in Indian subcontinent. The nearby pillared cupola known as Smith Folly is remnant of tower's 19th century restoration, which included an ill-advised attempt to add some more stories. In 1505, an earthquake damaged Qutb Minar. It was repaired by Sikandar Lodi. On 1st September 1803, a major earthquake caused serious damage. Major Robert Smith of British Indian Army renovated the tower in 1828 and installed a pillared cupola over the fifth story, creating a sixth. The cupola was taken down in 1848 under instructions from the Viscount Hardinge, who was the Governor General of India at the time. It was reinstated at ground level to the east of Qutb Minar, where it remains. It is known as Smith's Folly. It was added to the list of World Heritage Site in UNESCO in 1993. The Ghurids. The construction of Qutb Minar was planned and financed by an Afghani tribe, the Ghurids, who emigrated to the India and brought Islam with them. The Ghurids, historically known as Shansabians, were a clan of Tajik origin that hailed from Ghurs, the mountainous region of modern-day Western Afghanistan. In the late 11th century to the early 12th century, the different sect of nomadic clan united, losing its nomadic culture. During this time, they were converted to Islam. They then expanded into modern day India and quickly took control of substantial part of country. The Ghurids annexed the Multans and Unch in western Punjab in 1175-76, the northwestern region around Peshawar in 1177, and the region of Sindh in 1185-86. In 1193, Qutb ad-Din Aibak conquered Delhi and implemented a Ghurid governorship in province and congregational mosque. The Qutb Minar complex was founded in 1193. In the past, scholars believed that the complex was constructed to promote a conversion to Islam amongst Ghurids new subjects as well as symbols of Gurus, adherence to a social religion system. There is now new information to suggest that conversion to Islam was not a top priority of new annex, and instead the Gurud governors sought to make a synthesis of local culture and Islam through negotiation. The patrons and architects. Qutubuddin Aibak, a deputy of Muhammad of Ghor, who founded the Delhi Sultanate after Muhammad of Ghor's death, started the construction of Qutub Minar, first story, in 1199. Aibak's successor and son-in-law Shamshasuddin Iltutmish completed a further three stories. After a lightning strike in 1969 damaged the top story, the ruler at the time, Firuz Shah Tughlaq, replaced the damaged story and added one more. Sher Shah Suri also added an entrance while he was ruling, and the Mughal Emperor Humayun was in exile. Architecture. Persian, Arabic and Nankri in different sections of Qutub Minar reveals the history of its construction and the later restoration and repairs by Firuz Shah Tughlaq in 1351 to 1388 and Sikandar Lodi in 1489 to 1517. The height of Qutub Minar is 72.5 meters, making it the tallest minaret in the world, built of bricks. The tower tapers and has a 14.3 meters, 47 feet base diameter, reducing to 2.7 meters, 9 feet at the top of the peak. It contains a spiral staircase of 379 steps. The whole tower contains a spiral staircase of 379 steps. At the foot of the tower is the Quwat-ul-Islam Mosque. The minar tilts just over 65 cm from the vertical, while is constructed to be with a safe limit. Qutub Minar was an inspiration and prototype for many minarets and tower built. The Chand Minar and the Mini Qutub Minar bear resemblance to the Qutub Minar and inspired from it. The stories of Qutub Minar. The Qutub Minar vary in size, style, material due to various architects and builders constructing each section. The basement story of Qutub Minar. The Qutub Minar consists of five stories of red and grey sandstone. The lowest story, also known as basement story, was completed during lifetime of Ghiyath al-Dil Muhammad, a sultan during a Gurud dynasty. It is riveted with 12 semicircular and 12 flagged plisters that are placed in alternate order. This story is separated by the flanks and by stories balconies carried on mukarnats corbels. The story is placed on top of a lower circular plinth that is inscribed with a 12 pointer, start with a semicircle placed with each of these angles between the star's point. Here are also six horizontal bands with inscription inscribed in Nasq, a style of Islamic calligraphy, on the story. The inscriptions are as follows: Quran, Surah 2, verses 255 to 60, Quran, Surah 14, verses 22-23, and attributes of God. the name and titles of Ghiyath al-Din, Quran, Surah 18, verses 1 to 6, the name and titles of Muzil al-Din, Quranic quotation, and follows titles in the much restored inscription. The Amir, the most glorious and the great commander of the army. This level also has an inscription praising Muhammad of Ghor, the Sultan of Ghurids. The second, third and fourth story. The second, third and fourth stories were erected by Shamshashuddin Iltutmish, the first Muslim sovereign to rule from Delhi. He is considered to be the first of Delhi's Sultan dynastic line. The second and the third stories are also riveted with 12 semicircular and 12 flange pilasters that are placed in alternating order. These red stone columns are separated by flanges and by storied balconies carried on Mukarna's corbels. Prior to its reconstruction and reduction, the fourth story was also decorated with semicircular plisters. It was reconstructed in white marble and is relatively plain. The fifth story. In 1369, the fourth story was repaired after lightning struck the minarets. During the reconstruction, Sultan Firuz Shah Tughlaq elected to reduce the size of the fourth story and then separated it into two stories. Thank you. Qutub Minar, the tallest stone tower in India, was conceived by Qutubuddin Aibak, AD 1192 to 1210, as a tower of victory attached to Quat-ul-Islam Mosque. Qutubuddin completed the first story while the second, third, and the fourth were completed by his successor Iltutmish, AD 1211 to 36. When it was damaged by the lightning in 1326 and 1368, the fourth story was dismantled and reconstructed by Firuz Tughlaq, AD 1351-88, with an additional story making it a five-storied structure. Later on in 1503, Sikandar Lodi, AD 1489-1570, also carried out stone restoration in the upper stories. With a height of 238 feet and 379 steps, although it is the highest stone tower in India, it would be a pleasant surprise to know that its height is 5 feet less than that of Taj Mahal, 243 feet. The lowest story with alternate angular and circular fluting, the second with round ones, and the third with angular ones only. Keeping throughout the same alignment gives a pleasing vertical look to the minar. The projecting balconies with beautiful stalactite pendentives and its tiny alcoves further highlights its pleasing effect. The decorative inscription bands defines each story with its undulating curves. It has a diameter of 46 feet at the base and about 9 feet at the top. Tomb of Iltutmish, AD 1211 to 1236. The tomb of Shamshashuddin Iltutmish, AD 1211 to 36, son-in-law and successor of Qutbuddin Aibak, was built at about AD 1235 by Iltutmish himself. This is a landmark in Indo-Islamic architecture. The structure consists of a dome chamber with a central cenotaph. Its area is 9 square meter. The circular dome was carried on the squinch arches, which served to negotiate the difference in the shape between the square plane below and the circle above. It is believed that the original dome had fallen and was replaced by Firoz Shah Tughlaq, AD 1351 to 88. But even that did not survive. The interior on the west is occupied by three mihrabs, the central one higher and the ornamented with marbles to serve as a place for prayer. The tomb is profusely carved on the entrances and in the interior with inscription in Kufi and Nasq, characters in geometrical and Arabic pattern in Saracenic tradition.
Qutub Minar. The Qutub Minar, also spelled as Qutub Minar and Qutub Minar, is a minaret and victory tower that forms part of Qutub complex. It is a UNESCO World Heritage Site in the Mehrauli area of New Delhi, India. It is one of the most visited tourist spots in the city due to its being one of the earliest that survives in Indian subcontinent. It can be compared to the 62-meter all-brick minaret of Jam in Afghanistan of C. 1190, which was constructed a decade or so before the probable start of Delhi Tower. The surfaces of both are elaborately decorated with inscriptions and geometric patterns. The Qutub Minar has a shaft that is fluted with superb stalactite bracketing under the balconies at the top of each stage. In general, minarets were slow to be used in India and are often detached from the main mosque where they exist. A synthesis of South Asian and Islamic architecture. The Victory Tower is a symbol of synthesis of traditional Islamic architecture and the Southwestern Asian design. Elizabeth Lamburn, Islam Beyond Empire, Mosque and Islamic Landscape in India and the Indian Ocean Studies, the Introduction of Islam in South Asia and how the region influenced the Islamic religious architecture. These newly arrived Muslims from the Islamic West escaped the Mongol Empire and immigrated to India, where they constructed religious centers. The Qutub Minar served as a central marker to these new Muslim communities, as well being a reminder of Islam's presence in area. The architecture of minarets varies greatly from that of the typical style and design of mosques constructed in the Middle East. The style of these structures is heavily influenced by local architecture such as Indic temples. This affected the different material techniques and decorations that were used in the construction of Qutub Minar. The minaret is unique in that historically these towers, minarets were uncommon in South Asian Islamic design until the 17th century. This lag is due to slow adoption of typical Middle Eastern style in India. It is also detached from the main mosque, showcasing how the native culture affected the design of a Middle Eastern structure. The Qutub Minar is seen as the earliest and the best example of a fusion or synthesis of Hindu-Muslim traditions. According to Ved Prakash in his essay, The Qutub Minar from Contemporary and Near Contemporary Sources. Like many mosques built in South Asia during the time period, the minarets were constructed by Hindu laborers and craftsmen but overseen by Muslim architects. This led to a construction that synthesizes both Hindu and Islamic religious architecture. Since the craftsmen were Hindu and unfamiliar with the Quran, the inscriptions are compilation of disarranged Quranic texts and other Arabic expressions. History. The Qutub Minar was built over the ruins of Lal Kot, the citadel of Dilaka. Qutub Minar was begun after Quwat-ul-Islam Mosque, which was started around 1192 by Qutb-ud-Din Aibak, first ruler of Delhi Sultanate. It is usually thought that the tower is named for Qutb-ud-Din Aibak, who began it. It is also possible that it is named after Khwaja Qutb-ud-Din Bakhita Kaki, a 13th century Sufi saint, because Shamsuddin Iltutmish was a devotee of his. The Minar is surrounded by several historical significant monuments of Qutb complex. Quwat-ul-Islam Mosque to the northeast of Minar was built by Qutbuddin Aibak in AD 1198. It is earliest extant mosque built by Delhi Sultanate. It consists of rectangular courtyard enclosed by cloisters erected with carved columns and architectural members of 27 Hindu and Jain temples, which were demolished by Qutbuddin Aibak as recorded in his inscription on the main eastern entrance. Later, a lofty arched screen was erected and the mosque was enlarged by Shamsuddin Iltutmish, AD 1210 to 35. And Alauddin Khilji. The iron pillar in the courtyard bears an inscription in Sanskrit in Brahmin script of 4th century AD, according to which the pillar was set up as Vishnu Divaja, standard of Vishnu, God, on the hill known as Vishnupada in memory of a mighty king named Chandra. The mosque complex is one of the earliest that survives in Indian subcontinent. The nearby pillared cupola known as Smith Folly is remnant of tower's 19th century restoration, which included an ill-advised attempt to add some more stories. In 1505, an earthquake damaged Qutb Minar. It was repaired by Sikandar Lodi. On 1st September 1803, a major earthquake caused serious damage. Major Robert Smith of British Indian Army renovated the tower in 1828 and installed a pillared cupola over the fifth story, creating a sixth. The cupola was taken down in 1848 under instructions from the Viscount Hardinge, who was the Governor General of India at the time. It was reinstated at ground level to the east of Qutb Minar, where it remains. It is known as Smith's Folly. It was added to the list of World Heritage Site in UNESCO in 1993. The Ghurids. The construction of Qutb Minar was planned and financed by an Afghani tribe, the Ghurids, who emigrated to the India and brought Islam with them. The Ghurids, historically known as Shansabians, were a clan of Tajik origin that hailed from Ghurs, the mountainous region of modern-day western Afghanistan. In the late 11th century to the early 12th century, the different sect of nomadic clan united, losing its nomadic culture. During this time, they were converted to Islam. They then expanded into modern-day India and quickly took control of substantial part of country. The Ghurids annexed the Multans and Unch in western Punjab in 1175-76. The northwest region around Peshawar in 1177 and the region of Sindh in 1185-86. In 1193, Qutb ad-Din Aibak conquered Delhi and implemented a Ghurid governorship in province and congregational mosque. The Qutb Minar complex was founded in 1193. In the past, scholars believed that the complex was constructed to promote a conversion to Islam amongst Ghurids new subjects as well as symbols of Gurus, adherence to a social religion system. There is now new information to suggest that conversion to Islam was not a top priority of new annex, and instead the Gurud governors sought to make a synthesis of local culture and Islam through negotiation. The patrons and architects. Qutubuddin Aibak, a deputy of Muhammad of Ghor, who founded the Delhi Sultanate after Muhammad of Ghor's death, started the construction of Qutub Minar first story in 1199. Aibak's successor and son-in-law Shamshasuddin Iltutmish completed a further three stories. After a lightning strike in 1969 damaged the top story, the ruler at the time, Firuz Shah Tughlaq, replaced the damaged story and added one more. Sher Shah Suri also added an entrance while he was ruling, and the Mughal Emperor Humayun was in exile. Architecture. Persian, Arabic and Nagri in different sections of Qutub Minar reveals the history of its construction and the later restoration and repairs by Firuz Shah Tughlaq in 1351 to 1388 and Sikandar Lodi in 1489 to 1517. The height of Qutub Minar is 72.5 meters, making it the tallest minaret in the world, built of bricks. The tower tapers and has a 14.3 meters 47 feet base diameter, reducing to 2.7 meters 9 feet at the top of the peak. It contains a spiral staircase of 379 steps. The whole tower contains a spiral staircase of 379 steps. At the foot of the tower is the Quwat-ul-Islam Mosque. The minar tilts just over 65 cm from the vertical, while is constructed to be with a safe limit. Qutub Minar was an inspiration and prototype for many minarets in tower built. The Chand Minar and the Mini Qutub Minar bear resemblance to the Qutub Minar and inspired from it. The stories of Qutub Minar. The Qutub Minar vary in size, style, material due to various architects and builders constructing each section. The basement story of Qutub Minar. The Qutub Minar consists of five stories of red and grey sandstone. The lowest story, also known as basement story, was completed during lifetime of Ghiyat al-Dil Muhammad, a sultan during a Gurud dynasty. It is riveted with 12 semicircular and 12 flagged plisters that are placed in altering order. This story is separated by the flanks and by stories balconies carried on mukarnats corbels. The story is placed on top of a lower circular plinth that is inscribed with a 12 pointer, start with a semicircle placed with each of these angles between the star's point. Here are also six horizontal bands with inscription inscribed in nasq, a style of Islamic calligraphy, on the story. The inscriptions are as follows: Quran, Surah 2, verses 255 to 60, Quran, Surah 14, verses 22-23, and attributes of God. the name and titles of Ghiyat al-Din, Quran, Surah 18, verses 1 to 6, the name and titles of Muzil al-Din, Quranic quotation, and follows titles in the much restored inscription. The Amir, the most glorious and the great commander of the army. This level also has an inscription praising Muhammad of Ghor, the Sultan of Ghuritz. The second, third and fourth story. The second, third and fourth stories were erected by Shamshashuddin Iltutmish, the first Muslim sovereign to rule from Delhi. He is considered to be the first of Delhi's Sultan dynastic line. The second and the third stories are also riveted with 12 semicircular and 12 flange pilasters that are placed in alternating order. These red stone columns are separated by flanges and by storied balconies carried on Mukarna's corbels. Prior to its reconstruction and reduction, the fourth story was also decorated with semicircular plisters. It was reconstructed in white marble and is relatively plain. The fifth story. In 1369, the fourth story was repaired after lightning struck the minarets. During the reconstruction, Sultan Firuz Shah Tughlaq elected to reduce the size of the fourth story and then separated it into two stories. Thank you.
died, his tomb is there. And what he did, it is written there. He said, my last tomb is, my daughter will become true. Everybody will die one day. Make my tomb now. So, this is the Sultan tomb. Now, we take a nice